Angkor Kholi. Now, the reign of Angkor was a peaceful one. He was a nice king and all. Till he died and he was succeeded by his son Angkor Kholi. Now, when Angkor Kholi came into power, he tended to treat the Nawabs with contempt. He was very wicked. He would demand a lot of things from them. One of the things he required them to do was to kill all the elderly people of the Nawabs. And that was intentional because those times, people who are old are tend to be sources of wisdom. So he wanted to make sure that the Nawabs do not have any source of wisdom to tend to. So all the elderly people were instructed to be murdered. So even though that was done, the Nawabs managed to hide one elderly person. That was called Tegli. And then moving forward, after the murdering of the massacre of the people, King Angkor Kholi realized that due to his harshness, the Nawabs are probably planning to escape. So what he did was to come up with a plan that would construct a wall around the kingdom to prevent the escape. And in doing so, he instructed the Nawabs to mix mud with broken bottles and pots with their bare hands and feet. And you can imagine how excruciating and then painful that would be like. All right, so after he did that, he also wanted a lot of, he made a lot of demands from them. And then the Nawabs had to come up with a plan to escape. So what they did was that they went to consult the elderly man that was not murdered, that was hidden. They went to consult him. So the elderly man gave an advice that since you constructed the wall with clay, what you should do is that anytime anybody uses anything that is liquid, water, it could be, excuse me to say, pee, just pour it at the same spot on the clay wall. Because it is clay, with time, the clay becomes soft and it can go out. So all the women, when they wash, anytime they wash, they pour the water on the same spot of the wall. People go to pee there without the king knowing this is the plan. So one evening, when the wall became really soft, they went to consult the old man that they have hidden. And then the old man came and then offered a traditional prayer. Then he used his dagger to just perforate the wall, and then after the prayer, that part of the wall collapsed. So the thing is, every night, the king demands that the Nawabs drum, sing, and dance a song and a dance called Misegu or Husagu. So they were doing that as usual, and then the whole community went asleep. So what happened was that they made the elderly people and the people who didn't have a lot of energy to escape first, then followed by the people who were drumming. So after the escape of the elderly people, the people who are drumming knows that if they should also escape on the same route, when the king wakes up, they'll trace them and then come for them. So what happened was that during the escape of the last batch of the people who were drumming, they rather decided to walk backwards whilst escaping on the same footsteps that the people who escaped first did. And that would confuse anybody who is trying to come after them. All right, so this is, these two photos are showing a festival that we celebrate that is called Hobojojo. And the Hobojojo simply is done to commemorate that night where they walk backwards to escape their damnation. So you could see the girls dancing, then the boys drumming. So this photo or this festival is done to commemorate that special event in the life of the Nawabs. And then the escape route came to Ghana, and then that's how Camilius ended from Togo to Ghana. Although we still have some Nawabs living in Togo, Nigeria, and other places. All right, so I think it would not be fair if I end this presentation without you knowing how to make at least one common Nawab phrase. So I just have a simple exercise. So what I'll do is I will ask the question, what is your name? I'll ask it in Nawab. You don't even need to understand. Just make sure you give me the Nawab answer. And the Nawab answer is, so if I say Onkode, it means what is your name? So all I need you to do is to say Nyankoi Nye, and you call your name. So for instance, I say what Onkode, then I'll answer Nyankoi Nye Camilius. So I'll ask Onkoi De.
Onkoi De.
That's excellent. I think that's enough for you to survive at least one day in Ghana. Okay. So the second one that you may not have to say is just, where do you come from? And we say Afrika Metro. And you answer by saying Metro Bangladesh, Metro India, Metro Ghana, and all. All right. So this is just a bonus slide to give you hints about some interesting facts about Ghana. So first of all, Ghana is the second largest producer of cocoa in the world. So the next time you are eating some chocolate, there is a chance that that chocolate was produced from cocoa from Ghana, just bear it in mind. And then, moving on, Ghana is the second largest producer of gold in West Africa. So, interestingly, the former name of Ghana was Gold Coast. Why? Because the gold in Ghana was so abundant as those times when you are walking along the coast, you can even see some gold nuggets on the floor. But I'm talking about those times, not now. If not, I should be rich right now. Okay. So, the first sub-Saharan African country to get independence. And Ghana is ranked as the most peaceful country in West Africa. Ghana is also one of the most friendliest countries to tourists. And then some tourist sites include the historic castles, falls, parks, museums, etc. So, sorry about the blurriness of the pictures, but the first picture is a mineral castle that holds rich cultural heritage for the people of Africa. Then the one on the right is the museum of Dr. Kwame Nkrumah, the first president of Ghana, and then a very important figure in the history of Africa. And then this is Kakum National Park that you can walk on the canopies and see the animals below. Just make sure you don't fall into the forest and you'll be fine. Then that one is just some buildings over water called Musili Zone. So the next time that you are, or any time you are considering visiting Africa, I crave your indulgence to consider visiting Ghana. Akpenami. Thank you.
Akpenami.